Ready? Two tights, two tights. Odd. Five down. Oh!
Now they try the right side here. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Operating from the gun. Play. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Another example of just a dominant performance by this defense.
Yeah, you hear all the time about teams that try to steal signals from the other side and try and learn their signs and their tendencies. It's almost like they get the answers to the exam the night before and were well prepared for this final.
Good blocking there, nearly sprung him as it is. That was a 19-yard return. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Hey, come on. Hey,
what's the ball?
Tight right.
Odd. Five down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down. From the 22, here's second and eight.
I'm going to come back to you.
Off play action. Play. And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Back to throw. Play. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. The number seven usually lucky here. Seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
Tight end left. Tight end left. Odd. Five down. Stand up. Stand up.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
You got nothing.
Looking to throw. Clay throwing middle, and it's complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
First and 10 at the 40.
first and 10. Play. Got a man. It's Patterson complete. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
When the hitch routers run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage, and that's exactly what he got done there.
Only three there on the screen at second down. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Back to throw. Play. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. A short one here, complete to the tight end. And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Looking to throw. Play. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 33. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they try. To throw at him and beating him into the punch each and every.
Here we go. Set. Let's go.
Tight ends Ringo. Tight ends on Ringo. How'd it go?
Throwing after the interception. Play. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
They don't want it.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10.
Let's get it.
Back to throw. Play. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. An incomplete pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. Looking to throw. Play. Well, this one complete to Smith. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33.
Well, as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, well, you know how much coaches love run after catch. But you know what they love even more? Completion.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it, cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
So a change of possession here on the punt. Catch and run. 49 yards. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. What a game this defense continues to play, huh?
Yeah, they've been aggressive from the first snap, and they've controlled this ball game. But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you've got to match that aggressiveness. No points so far in this game. Moving the football, got to be that way to go against them and try and get some points on the board.
And I'm curious, on the defensive side, if they stay aggressive, because you know they want to pitch this shutout.
Yeah, they have to be aggressive, but they also have to be smart about it as well, because one mistake can turn into 6 points.
And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. Only able to pick up 2, and that leads us to 3rd and goal.
Sometimes it pays to be lucky rather than good. That was not even the intended receiver on that pass.
But still able to haul it in for the reception. This defense continues to be good on 3rd down. I mean, they haven't allowed a touchdown offensively. Are you saying, let's go for this? Let's try to get it in the end zone.
I don't know about that because of what you just described. They've been so good, and they don't give up the big play that you would expect in downs 1 through 3. Why should 4th down be any different? True. You might want to go ahead and kick the field goal.
Chicago Bears have